Hey guys, my name is Kriantje and welcome to episode 1 of my Applied Energistics 2 tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. Thanks to the incredible amount of feedback that I've gotten on my Logistics Pipes tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10 and the huge amount of requests that I've gotten to do a similar kind of series on Applied Energistics 2, I decided to give it a go as Applied Energistics is also one of my favorite mods out there to mess around with, mainly due to the crazy amount of functionality you can do with this and implement it in almost any situation in your world. So in this series I will be guiding you guys how you're able to make both the very basic networks able in Applied Energistics 2, but also the top tier networks, things like auto crafting and everything having to do with that. So in this episode we will be starting to talk about the preparations that are needed to actually start with Applied Energistics 2, mainly about things like world gen, but also very basic creation of the actual crystals in the game. So let's get started. First off is stage 1, exploration. While venturing through the overworld, you might have seen these structures laying around. These are spheres made out of skystone. They are quite rare, but they do have a good chance to appear while venturing quite a lot. This can also appear both above ground and underground, so also keep an eye out for these structures while mining. Like I said, they are made out of skystone, which is quite a hard material that can only be mined with a pickaxe with a level that is similar to diamonds or anything above that. Right in the middle of these skystone spheres, or the center I should say, you will find yourself a skystone chest. Do keep in mind that while actually seeing them in your world, they aren't hollow, so you will have to do a little bit of digging straight to the center to find these chests. In these chests, you have a chance to find these presses. These are the Inscriber Silicon Press, Logic Press, Engineering Press, and Calculation Press. For pretty much everything you will need in a Applied Energistics network, you will need at least these 4 presses, as they are the very basics of what you actually need to get started. That is pretty cool. Do keep in mind that they have a chance to appear either duplicates, of course, because they are not limited to the actual one per chest, but if you're lucky, you will also be able to find multiple presses in one chest. So yeah, that is pretty cool. While mining, you might have found these 2 ores added by Applied Energistics 2 too. They are the Surtus Quartz ore and the Charged Surtus Quartz ore. While mining, you will get either the Surtus Quartz crystals or the corresponding Charged Surtus Quartz crystals. There's also a good way to see which ore is which, as the Charged Surtus Quartz ore, instead of having a different name, of course, in the Wayla mod, as shown above, would also emit blue particles, so that is pretty interesting. While mining with a pickaxe, you have a chance to get multiple of them, especially when using something like a fortune pickaxe. So keep in mind that you will need quite a lot of these, so it's quite useful to do a little bit of mining beforehand, before wanting to get started with the Applied Energistics 2 mod. Next up is stage 2, preparation. This is where you put to use the actual presses that we found in these skystone spheres. What you need to do is get yourself these presses and make yourself an inscriber press. The recipe is shown right now. The inscriber press uses some power, which for tutorial purpose I hooked up to a creative energy cell, but will accept both normal Applied Energistics power and redstone flux. So any mod that adds redstone flux cabling or a power bank, for example, will be able to power this inscriber. What you do is you get both the presses and one of these 4 corresponding items, which are either the silicon, which you get from pulverizing sand, the pure Surtus Quartz crystals, which I will show you guys in a minute how to get, gold ingots or diamond ingots. What you do is you open the inscriber and you will see 3 slots on the left side, 1 slot in the middle and 3 slots on the right. The top and bottom slots are pretty much for the actual presses. At least the top one is for the actual press and the bottom one is for something we will use later on. The center slot right here is for these 4 items. And then the output, of course, is the output you will get in the actual inscriber with a little bit of a percentage bar right here where you can actually see how far the progress of the inscriber currently is. Then also right here, you will be able to see some upgrades, which is not something we will be messing around just yet, but in the end, you will also be able to add something like speed upgrades to the inscriber. So what you do is you put in the press, which you can either shift right click or just put it in yourself, and then the corresponding material. The silicon press will only work with silicon. The calculation press will only work with pure stratus quartz crystals. The logic press will only work with gold ingots. And the inscriber engineering press will only work with diamonds. Do keep that in mind though. So as you can see, while I'm putting this in, the progress bar will go up and I will get the corresponding items that fit with these presses. The silicon press will give you printed silicon. The inscriber calculation press will give you the calculation circuit. The logic press will give you the logic circuit. And the engineering press will give you the printed engineering circuit. Pretty cool. Then what you're able to do is actually put these items to use to make some actual circuits. For this, you will need both a piece of silicon, either one of these other three circuits, and a piece of redstone. What you do is you put the silicon in the top slot, the circuits in the middle, so either the printed engineering circuit, in the bottom slot, either the printed engineering circuit, printed calculation circuit, or the printed logic circuit, and a piece of redstone in the middle, and you will get yourself the full-blown processor or circuit that is meant to this thing. So in this case, we get yourself an engineering processor. When using a calculation circuit, you will get yourself a calculation processor, and a logic circuit, you will get yourself a logic processor. These will be used in further stages, so keep that in mind, as it is already good to know how you can actually get them. Because some specific recipes require charged stratus quartz instead of regular stratus quartz, it is a good thing to also make yourself a charger, recipe shown right now. This is a block that is able to convert regular stratus quartz into charged stratus quartz with the cost of just a little bit of power. So just like the inscriber, just hook up some power. This thing only works with power from the top, by the way. Right click the actual crystal in, or you can pump it in or pipe it in or whatever preferred method you have. You will see a bit of lightning effects coming off of this thing, and you got yourself a charged stratus quartz crystal. Pretty cool. Next up is crystal creation and recreation. This is a step where you are able to both create the pure crystals and actual flux crystals. Let's start with those first. Flux crystals are created when combining charged stratus quartz, nether quartz, and a piece of redstone in a puddle of water. This can be pretty much anything, whether it be a full-blown block of water, or an ocean, or a river, whatever your preferred method is, as long as they are in the same block. What you do is you toss all three of them in. You will see some particles, lightning particles being emitted from them, and you'll get yourself two flux crystals for each of this recipe. Pretty awesome. Next up is the creation of pure crystals. Pure crystals are made when combining a piece of sand and a piece of the corresponding dust of the pure crystal that you want to make, either the pure flux crystal, the pure stratus quartz crystal, or the pure nether quartz crystal, and you get yourself two of the seeds that are correspondent to these crystals. What you do is you get yourself these seeds, and just like the creation of flux crystals, you toss them in a pool of water. This is a very slow process, so if you want to do this, I would recommend you either do this very early on in your game, or find a way to chunk load the area where you actually dropped the seeds in, because trust me when I say it will take a long time, like several Minecraft days, to develop into a full-blown seed. There are three main stages of these seeds, as you can see right here. Either the 33% seed, which will look like this, 66% looks like this, and the full-blown pure crystal, which will appear like this. Just like the tooltip says, the item won't despawn, so there's no need to worry about the items actually going away when dropping them in a pool of water and then leaving to do something else in the meantime, because they won't disappear. Pretty awesome. The reason to make pure crystals instead of using the regular crystals that you get from either mining or the recipe is because you get two of them, just for the cost of sand. For most regular recipes, you're able to use either the regular crystals or the pure crystals, as it doesn't really matter. But of course, you will get two of the crystals instead of just one, which you get from normally mining. Do keep in mind that some recipes do specifically require the regular crystals, so you don't want to turn all of your regular crystals into the pure variety. But, you know, most of them will. Next up is crystal acceleration. This is already getting a little bit more complicated than the other few steps, but I hope you guys will be able to actually follow what I'm going to show you guys. To demonstrate this, I got myself this little contraption set up. This is made using an energy acceptor, recipe shown right now, some ME glass cabling, and 4 crystal growth accelerators. I also got myself an ME toggle brush right here, just so I can turn on and off the power to these crystal growth accelerators. So let me quickly run by what this exactly does. First of all, we got ourselves a creative energy cell right here, which is the actual power source. Again, you will be able to use any RF or applied energistics to power source, but for a standalone system, this works just fine. The next up is the energy acceptor. This is the block that actually powers the crystal growth accelerators right here, as they do require power. Connected to that, I got myself an ME toggle bus, just so I can flip this on and off with a redstone signal. And connected to that, I got myself a loop of ME glass cabling connected to these crystal growth accelerators. Do keep in mind the orientation when placing these crystal growth accelerators, as they will only connect with cabling on two sides. As shown right here, they will only connect to the blank or more blank side, and not to the actual side with the stripes on it. The sides with the stripes is also the only side that will actually increase the growth of the crystals. So placing it like so, let me quickly see, yeah. Placing it like so would also work if you use this side, for example, as the spot of water, but don't use right this right here because that won't function. The reason why you want to make this is because this will speed up the growth of these seeds by a lot. Instead of having to wait loads of Minecraft days, it's like less than 2 or 3 minutes. So let me quickly see, turn this system back on. You will see that these things are powered both by the Wayla tooltip saying device online and the texture pretty much flashing purple. So that's a pretty clear indicator. Then what you can do is just drop in the seed. And we wait just a little bit. Let's see how far these seeds have gone in the meantime. Let me quickly put these seeds away. They are at 1%. That's, it's decent, but like still extremely slow. And I'm recording this pretty much straight after this part, so that's not that fast. And how far are these right now? In the few minutes that, or few seconds that I put them here, yeah, already at 20%, 19%, and 18%. Just in the small intervals where I dropped them in, you can see they already have a percentage of a difference. That's quite a lot. So this is definitely the way to go if you have the resources for it, as it will just save you a bunch of time. Also, you will be able to see that these things are actually functioning by the amount of particles coming off from these seeds, as shown right here. Pretty awesome. And that's pretty much it for this video, guys. I definitely hope you guys found it very educational. If you have, please let me know down in the comment section. And also, of course, if you have any suggestions. Next episode, we will start talking about the very basics of a ME network and probably how you're able to store items. Pretty interesting. So thanks for watching, guys. Please leave a rating. Like always, if you have any suggestions, you can find the link down in the description to the dedicated forum of this page, so you're able to chat with the other viewers and, of course, give your feedback. And I'll see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.